Welcome to Harbor Highlights. Highlights from the 8th grade trip to Washington, D.C. and from our American Heart Association Assembly. This and more, so stay tuned.
Good day, I'm AJ.
And I'm Avion.
A few weekends ago, the 8th graders that signed up to go on the Washington, D.C. trip had three fun-packed days of learning about our nation's history.
The group learned so much on the trip and was able to see our nation's history come alive.
Here are just a few memories from the trip.
The trip started early at 4 a.m. Friday, leaving the school parking lot at lot to the Grand Rapids Airport. Over 70 of us boarded the planes headed to Washington, D.C. We hit the ground running, headed our first spot in National Archives. Here they have the actual documents that our country is founded on, the Declaration of Independence, the U.S. Constitution, and the Bill of Rights, as well as many other important documents. After a quick lunch, we were amazed by the National Cathedral. The cathedral features Gothic-style architecture with ribboned pillars and vaulted ceilings. There are many statues. The cathedral is decorated with sculptures of important people in our history, including President Lincoln and Rosa Parks. The cathedral crypts hold the remains of President Woodrow Wilson and other important national figures such as Helen Keller and her teacher, Anne Sullivan.
From there, we went to the Air and Space Museum, where students learned about the invention of flight and the forces needed to make flight possible. We could also see famous planes in history and a spacecraft for a lunar landing on the moon. We were lucky to avoid a rainstorm on the way to our next spot. The Roosevelt Memorial is a favorite for many. It houses four rooms, one room for each term of his presidency. That's right, Roosevelt was the only president that served four terms. The memorial displayed some of his amazing quotes that should continue to guide us as Americans today. One of the rooms for his term during the Great Depression features four huge rolling pillars with the negative indentations that is used to create four murals showing the different initiatives used to get our economy rolling again, literally, during the Depression. From then, we grabbed some dinner before heading to our last few spots of the night.
The MLK Memorial is pretty amazing. The statue creates a mountain with Dr. King looking across the basin over to the Jefferson Memorial. Some say Dr. King is looking to the future, waiting for his dream to come true. The memorial features many quotes that we should be using to reach his dreams still today.
From there, we visited the Korean Memorial that displays etchings of the many soldiers who lost their lives or served during the Korean War.
Our last stop on this chilly evening was the Lincoln Memorial. Inside the gigantic Greek-style building sits a 19-foot-tall Lincoln staring across reflecting pool and down the National Mall, past the World War II Memorial, and at the Washington Monument. The walls are inscribed with Lincoln's second inaugural address and the Gettysburg Address. On the granite platform is the exact spot where Dr. King delivered his I Have a Dream speech. We checked into the hotel. Four kids per room, and I think it's safe to say that we were all pretty tired. In the morning, we get a full breakfast in the hotel. Saturday, our first stop was the White House, and then we went to visit the Vienna Memorial. There are flowers and memorials left by friends and loved ones. Students were able to find their own last names and wonder if this is a distant relative. One student was able to find his great uncle and do a rubbing of his name. Along the way, there is a memorial dedicated to the women who served and another one called Three Servicemen, which honors the African American and Latino Americans who also served in Vietnam. The highlight of our day may have been the trip to the nation's Capitol building. We were able to take a tour to see the dome that is adorned with artwork and carvings that tell the story of the birth of our country. The fresco on the dome reflects the great art of Michelangelo in the Sistine Chapel in Italy. Other original paintings on the wall depict pivotal events in our history. We also toured the original chamber of the Senate that now houses the statue donated from each day honoring a resident who impacted our country's history. There is also a replica of Lady Liberty that stands perched on the top of the Capitol.
We took a tunnel under the roads that led us to the Library of Congress. This is another gorgeous building that features the actual books from Thomas Jefferson's original library. He was an avid reader, as you can see. It also features the very first book that was printed from Gutenberg Printing Press in 1455.
We had a picnic lunch before stopping by the famous Iwo Jima statue. The memorial was inspired by the iconic 1945 photograph of six Marines raising a U.S. flag atop Mount Suribachi during the Battle of Iwo Jima in World War II.
The next stop was Arlington Cemetery. This cemetery is dedicated to the men and women who have served our country. Arlington is home of the memorial for the Tomb of the Unknown Soldiers. Many soldiers from World War I, World War II, Korean War, and Vietnam were injured so badly they could not be identified. This memorial contains the remains of a few of these unknown soldiers to give honor to those unknown or missing soldiers. The tomb has been guarded since 1937 with a meticulous routine 24 hours a day. Arlington also is the final resting place for President John F. Kennedy.
Food is never lacking on this trip. Saturday night, we ate at our favorite Mexican restaurant before our last stops for the night. We were able to visit the Jefferson Memorial, which is similar in architecture to the Pantheon in Rome. The Jefferson Memorial walls are also inscribed with meaningful words for then and today.
Our last stop of the night was to a tourist shop to pick up some souvenirs from our trip. Back at the hotel, we had some hangout time.
Sunday morning, we started our day by visiting the Pentagon Memorial. This memorial remembers those that lost their lives in the plane and in the Pentagon on 9/11.
Then we headed to Mount Vernon to see the home of George and Martha Washington. They were known for housing many guests at their estate, and their home has the rooms to prove it. Overlooking the Potomac River, Mount Vernon is a beautiful spot.
Sunday was sunny and warm, and we visited the World War II Memorial. It was crowded with people. The memorial contains much symbolism and holds a beautiful view of the Lincoln Memorial and the Washington Monument.
After a quick lunch, we were fortunate to be able to go to the newest Smithsonian, the Museum of African American History and Culture. The museum works as a timeline from slave trade to freedom. There are original documents and stories of these African American heroes that were forced laborers profiting wealthy landowners. The museum highlights the civil rights movement and had special displays for African American heroes such as Barack Obama and the influence of Oprah Winfrey. The museum also had a whole floor celebrating the music, arts, entertainment culture of African Americans and how it has influenced us as a nation.
Our final stop was the Museum of U.S. History. The museum holds the original Old Glory flag, has displays about advances in science and technology, a walking tour of our nation's history from its beginning until now, including all the wars and conflicts. It talks about the different presidencies and hold gowns of the first ladies.
One of the greatest parts of our trip is our leader, J.D. He made the history come alive on the bus rides and at the memorials with his stories and wealth of information. We will miss him. It's time to head back. We've walked about 8 miles a day, but it's all worth it, and we are still smiling. This trip provided so many new experiences and adventures, and of course, look into our country's history. And this makes us think about what legacy we will help to create for future generations.
Current 7th grade students, now is the time to begin planning and saving for your Washington D.C. trip that can happen when you are in 8th grade.
Attending an information meeting is the first step to making it happen. You and your parents can hear from the trip leaders and learn about payment options so you have almost an entire year to save.
There will be two meetings, and students will from either middle school can attend either meetings. There are Wednesday, April 17th in the Harbor Lights Library or Tuesday, April 23rd in the Mag Bay Cafe. Both meetings will be at 7 p.m. Experience your nation's capital.
Now over to this week's general announcements.
Hi, I'm Caleb.
And I am Michaela.
The lunch specials are Monday Salisbury steak and seasoned carrots, Tuesday chicken and cheese enchiladas, and Wednesday chicken drumstick.
Thursday chicken egg roll, and Friday creamy pasta Alfredo with chicken.
Knitting club meets today after school. The final meeting for Calling All Colors will be Monday, April 29, so group, don't miss it.
Thank you, 8th graders, for doing a great job during testing. 6th graders will be taking MCEP April 30th and May 2nd, and 7th graders will be taking MCEP May 14th and 16th.
Here is a free summer camp opportunity and a chance to see what college is like. Davenport College is a free math camp exploring puzzles, games, and codes.
The dates are July 15th, 18th from 9 to noon at Highland Campus, and you then get lunch after. To sign up, go to the link on the screen.
Congratulations, students, for your support of the American Heart Association. We raised $900 and students had a fun time being active at our assembly. Here are some highlights from the event before break.
Thanks again, students and staff, for your donations and for those who participated in the dodgeball tournament.
Now let's send it over to find about this week's sports report.
Hi, I'm Max.
And I'm Jacob. First, boys and girls track has two meets this week. Monday against Hudsonville Riley and Thursday against Lakeshore Middle. What's that all?
Girls soccer teams play only on Tuesday this week against Holland East.
Tuesday, the black tennis team is challenging Creekside Middle away, and the white team is home against Green Haven.
On Thursday, the black tennis team is challenging Hamilton at home, and the white team is away against Cityside.
For boys lacrosse, they play Monday against Spring Lake at 6:45 and Wednesday against Highland Christian at 5:30. Both are at home.
If you would like to play a sport next year, make sure you are planning to go to the free physical night at Lakeshore Orthopedics on Tuesday, May 21 from 6 to 8 p.m.
Now is the time to sign up for West Isles Sports Camps. The form can be found at wolpanthers.com under the More tab, and at the bottom it says Camps.
This is a great way to meet coaches, teammates, and improve your technical skills with the sport.
School of Basketball with Coach Haglund will also be running this summer at the high school gyms. There is a 3rd through 7th grade session and 8th through 12th.
They are 2-hour sessions that meet twice a week. These sessions are skill focused on ball handling and shooting. The email is listed to pre-register.
Now back to the anchors.
Thanks. Next week we have some updates on the construction that has been going on and future plans for our school.
Thanks for watching our announcements.
Have a great week and remember that every day is a new day to make it happen.
Bye.